An iron coin with one side cut and shaped into a crude claw tool, perhaps to remove nails.
Greetings. Did you bring anything to trade? Anything we could use?
Hello there.
You're the one that came with Jacob. I have something to ask.
The followers of the prophet fled, but they were attacked in Syria. What can I help you with?
Jacob told me you've got a knack for exploring. There are more old places, tombs, all around the valley. You may have seen the wards placed there to frighten children. It's not superstition. Those places are dangerous, but they also hold relics of our former glory. Not just trinkets, but knowledge. I believe we need that wisdom now more than ever. A decade ago, I'd have gone myself, but now I could use your skills. The scouts tell me you've already been inside one of the old tombs. Would you share what you've learned with us?
Of course. They belong to your people.
We don't have much, but I have these old coins. If gold has value to you, I can give you some for every secret you find.
Thank you, Lara. Our people have been warned. That should give them time to evacuate. Meet me in the upper village. I'm gathering our forces here.
All right. A map of some sort, but I can't quite read the words. Aurora, the physician.
The The road to Katesh was long and hard. Infirmity, illness, and injury abounded. Aurora was a believer trained in the ways of Hippocrates and the great Roman healers. It is because of her that so many survived the journey to Katesh. It is her legacy that knowledge of healing continues to be passed down among believers.
Thank you. I'm running out of fletching. We need more.
You're still putting forward to an arrow.
Jacob, helicopters are headed your way.
Get here as fast as you can. Get behind the barricade. Move, move. Look out. Stay under cover.
Resistance will be
pull back. Stay together.
Lay down your weapons or you will be shot.
Where is the divine source? Tell me!
Stop! Don't hurt anyone else!
Where is it?
Wait! Wait! There's a map. The Atlas. It will show you the way.
Okay. Tell me about this Atlas.
Hey.
This is mine.
We can't hold it just any longer.
Come on, stop them.
We're going to lose the village.
Just try that again. Come on. If I burn, you burn. Not gonna keep you safe.
We should have killed her.
You have nothing to show for your efforts. Perhaps she'll succeed where you're failing.
I will not fail.
Trinity will step in if you do. And you know what that means? I'm expendable. They have no interest in my survival. I need the power of the Source.
And you will have it. Don't lose faith, Anna. This is God's will. Our success is inevitable.
Please, just find it. My time is running out.
Endured so much. These final barriers you have set before me. These sins you have forced me to commit. They must have a purpose. Only you can show me the way. Grant me strength to continue for her. For you. For Trinity. Please. Show me the way.
Stay with me. Stay with me.
I'm sorry. Your people don't deserve this.
It is our chosen path. Our duty. It's never been easy.
I understand what it's like to lose people. Trinity won't stop, will they?
I doubt it. They have many resources.
And the Atlas?
It's an ancient map to the old city. The Trinity won't find it at that tower. Many of my people live in those ruins. They won't be prepared for what's coming.
I can help them, Jacob.
Will you do this for us? Or for that which you seek?
Right now, they're one and the same.
I'll be back with reinforcements after I've tended to the wounded.
Yes?
I need bandages.
What is it?
We're in bad shape, Jacob. The attack left us in shambles, and we have no one to send to the Acropolis.
I know.
I'll see
I
to
still
the
can't see straight.
We have to get them to someplace safe. When that's done, gather anyone still able to fight. Hold still.
Can I help?
You already have. If it wasn't for you, more of us would
be. Will they do that? Send a
Fires still rage in the outer districts. The last of the wooden buildings will be consumed by nightfall. The heart of our city is gone, buried beneath the ice. I can take some small solace in the fact that the Mongol invaders were killed, alongside the Prophet's warriors who died to save us. And the Prophet himself? No one has seen him since the morning after the siege ended. We need his wisdom. Now more than ever, we do not have enough food to feed those who survived. Some believe the worst is over, but I fear that is not the case.
Ask them that. Hello. I need to get some air. Stay here and don't close your eyes.
some kind of burial chamber. A basket made of silver. Certainly meant to be decorative, but someone's been using it to carry grain.
Be far from our home, but that does not make us barbarians. When our loved ones pass on, as far too many have this season, we treat them with respect. When we did not yet have a vineyard to produce wine, we washed the dead with lake water. When we lacked the looms to spin the death shroud, we wrapped our departed in skins and hides. We carried few coins with us, but now we forge our own, so that our blessed dead can pay passage to the next world. I only wish that the price was not so high. The very man.
Interesting. Did they embalm their dead? A golden chalice fit for a king. Or a prophet. It was made here in Katash. I can read this now. And it's pointing somewhere. Jacob, it's a mess up here. There's no sign of your people.
Sophia might have taken them into the catacombs beneath the tower. But I lost contact with her.
All right, I'll look for her there.
We're almost done evacuating the wounded here. I'll join you soon.
I'm not too late. God, no.
The creatures of this valley were unfamiliar to us. Once. But now they are our brothers and sisters, as much as any relative of blood. You can learn much about the creatures of our valley from the hunters, but they find worth in death. We must also find the gifts our brothers give while they are still alive. In the nests of birds, you'll find feathers for the fletchers to craft arrows. Ask for what you need, and the valley will provide.
It has been months since the snows of the mountain buried the heart of Katesh. We sent men to search for survivors or food, but none have returned. Sounds drift up from the glaciers, but if people still lived entombed inside, I do not know. It could be the shifting ice, but I will be the first to admit, it sounds like the voices of men. Perhaps the ghosts of the Prophet's warriors still patrol the frozen streets. We will send no more of our people inside. We have to accept that the Prophet and the city are lost to us, and that we are now on our own.